Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin the current affairs that can be asked in your RBI-SEBI NABARD examinations in the phase one. And particularly, these are the questions that are of relevance from your banking awareness point of view, as well as we will be covering questions that are of national importance. So all of these make up your general awareness complete. Okay, so let's begin this video. So here we have the first question: who has been appointed as the CEO of Target Olympic Podium Scheme? So we have the five options: Anita Baghel, Rajni Sharma, P.K. Garg, Chandan Mishra Dwivedi, S. Priyanka. So out of these options, option C, P.K. Garg, is the right answer. So Sports Authority of India has made this appointment for the Target Olympic Podium Scheme. Now do remember that P.K. Garg has also served in the Indian Navy. He has also won the Arjun Award and Major Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna Award, which was the earlier Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. He belongs to the sport of sailing. Okay, so these much informations are enough for you to remember for your examination. You can skip the years here very well, because years are just for your information. Nobody is going to ask you the years in which P.K. Garg has won the Arjun Award or this Major Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna Award. Okay. Now let's discuss some facts about the scheme as well. So in 2014, first of all, Target Olympic Podium Scheme. So basically, we have to target the Olympic podium. So this scheme was launched so that Indian athletes can win medals in the Olympics. And this scheme was launched in 2014 to make Indian athletes win medals at the 2016 Rio Olympics and Tokyo Olympics of 2020. Okay, now both of these events have passed. Therefore, the focus of this scheme is now on the upcoming Olympics of 2024 Paris Olympics and 2028 Los Angeles Olympics. Okay, so do remember this as well. Now in 2018, this scheme was revamped in order to introduce the concept of technical team or establish the technical team that can help the tops athletes in their holistic preparation. So in 2018, basically the technical support team was established under this tops scheme. Now under this scheme, what are the benefits that are provided to the athletes? They get foreign training, international competition, training, equipment and coaching camp. Also, they get a monthly stipend of ₹50,000 at present. So do remember this as well, okay? Now, this Mission Olympic Cell, you can understand it as the implementing agency of this TOPS scheme. So this Mission Olympic Cell is a body that was created under the scheme to implement the scheme, as well as to select the athletes, the institutions, training institutions where the athletes will get training as well as coaches under this TOPS scheme. Next is that in order to help athletes in winning medals in Tokyo Olympics, Paris 2024 and Los Angeles 2028 Olympics, TOPS National Center of Excellence are being set up in 14 priority disciplines or sports areas. Okay, so these were the facts related to this Target Olympic Podium Scheme. A very easy scheme. From the name, the objective is clear of this scheme. I hope that you have understood the scheme better now. Okay, do remember that the chairman of this Mission Olympic Cell is the Director General of Sports Authority, who is at present Sandeep Pradhan. Okay, next question is, what is the name of the vehicle launched by DRDO for testing missiles against the UAVs or drones? Abhyas, Dhruv, Prahar, Dhanush, Vijayanta. So out of these options, the right answer is option A. Abhyas is the name of the vehicle that has been recently tested by the DRDO. So let's look at the facts related to Abhyas first, and then we will look what this Abhyas vehicle is or what is the purpose of this vehicle. Okay. So this was tested from the integrated test range which is in Chandipur in Odisha. Okay. Abhyas is designed and developed by Aeronautical Development Establishment of DRDO. So this is a subsidiary of DRDO in Bangalore. Now, it is a high-speed expendable aerial target, which is short formed as HEAT. What is the use? Abhyas is basically is the target, is the aerial target. Okay. So this has been developed in order to test the missiles which can hit this target. How efficient are our missiles? Basically, this will help in testing the missiles. Okay. How efficiently are our missiles working will be tested by this Abhyas vehicle. Okay. So it will be used for testing missiles against the UAVs or drones. Abhyas will act as the UAE for the purpose of evaluation. Okay. So these were the facts. Now I'm going to show you what is Abhyas in reality, so that you can better understand it. This is Abhyas, okay? Okay, so you don't have to go into the specifications. It is just for the purpose of information. So guys, this was Abhyas. Okay. I hope that now you have understood what Abhyas is. It is basically an aircraft that has been created by DRDO in order to tackle the drones or UAVs. Apart from this, if you haven't understand the functioning of this Abhyas vehicle, then you don't even need to understand it, because this is not a defense examination, it is a banking examination. So general knowledge regarding the defense and everything, general knowledge about the general things would be asked from you in your examination. Okay, so don't cram your mind that what was the vehicle for. So the basic purpose is to stop the aerial attacks. That's why we have created Abhyas. Next question is, which film has been chosen as the India's official entry to the 94th Oscar Awards? Okay, so The World Before Her, India's Daughter, Insai, Meru, Kuzhangal. These are the options, out of which Kuzhangal is the right answer, which is a Tamil movie, and it has been chosen as India's official entry to the Oscars. Oscars are also known as Academy Awards, and this would be the 94th edition of these awards. And do remember, these awards are for the year 2021, but the award ceremony or the final announcement of the winners will take place on March 27, 2022. Los Angeles is the place where these awards are given. Okay, so from India, Kuzhangal, which means pebbles in English, has been chosen, and P.S. Vinod Raj is the director of this film. This film has also won a very prestigious award, which is called Tiger Award, at the 50th International Film Festival of Rotterdam, Netherlands, in this year only. Okay, so do remember this fact as well. And as we know that these awards have not been announced, therefore we should restrict ourselves to this much information only. Okay? Who has won the Satyajit Ray Lifetime Achievement Award 2021? Martin Scorsese, Steven Zabo, Steven Spielberg, both A and B, both B and C. So here the right answer is option D, both A and B. Now the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting has announced these awards, and remember that the Satyajit Ray Lifetime Achievement Award is given at the India International Film Festival of India, which will take place in Goa from November 20 to 2028. Remember that the official location of this festival is Goa only. Every year this festival takes place in Goa. Okay, and this would be the 52nd session or edition. And the dates are November, but you don't have to remember the dates. It's just for information again. Okay, so this year's Lifetime Achievement Award has been given to Martin Scorsese, who is a Hollywood director, and Steven Zabo, who is a Hungarian filmmaker. Okay, so before I move ahead, I would like to ask a question from you, and that question is, in which year was the Satyajit Ray Lifetime Achievement Award introduced by the government of India? Okay, so this is your question. Do tell me in the comment section below. Next is that alongside this 52nd International Film Festival of India, BRICS Film Festival will also be held, and in that festival, films from the BRICS nations, which are the BRICS nations, Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. So films from these nations will also be showcased alongside this festival, and this would be the first time that BRICS Film Festival will take place. Okay, and the opening film of International Film Festival of India is The King of All the World. Okay, now you don't have to memorize this fact thoroughly, as especially you can skip this part because nobody asks about the opening film, but still we don't have to take any chance. If such kind of a question is made in your examination, then you should be aware of the fact that this movie was the opening movie of this IFFI 52nd session. Okay, who has been appointed as the MD and CEO of ICRA? Ramnath Krishnan is the right answer. Okay, how many countries have been identified as the country of concern on climate by National Intelligence Estimate on Climate Report? So first of all, this report has been prepared by US, and this report has identified a total number of 11 countries including India as countries of concern. And do pay attention to this thing, that this report has linked climate change with the stability in a country or a region. Okay, so if the climate change is severe, if the country which is facing the impacts of the climate change is in critical condition, then there are high chances that internal conflict can break out in that country, or it can indulge in geopolitical tensions. For example, it has cited as examples the relations of India and Pakistan. So if the situation of climate change worsens in Pakistan, then there are high chances that in order to protect its image, the government of Pakistan can initiate a war against India. Okay, so this is the estimation that this report has provided us with, that with the increase of climate change and its adverse impacts, the political, social, economic stability of countries as well as regions will be impacted, and they will reach at the edge. Okay, so this is the focus of this report. Now let's discuss this report in detail. So 11 countries including India are the country of concern. These are highly vulnerable in terms of their ability to prepare for and respond to environmental and societal crises caused by the climate change. Global warming will also increase geopolitical tensions and risk to US national security in the period up to 2040. Countries of particular concern are Afghanistan, India, Pakistan, Myanmar, Iraq, North Korea, Guatemala, Haiti, Honduras, Nicaragua and Colombia. So these are the 11 countries that have been identified as the countries of particular concern. Now, heat, drought, water availability and ineffective government make Afghanistan especially worrying. So all of these are the situations that the people are facing in Afghanistan. Water disputes are a key geopolitical flashpoint in India and the rest of the South Asia. So water is one issue that the entire South Asian region is dealing with. Climate change is likely to increase the risk of instability in countries in Central Africa as well as small island states in the Pacific, which are the most vulnerable areas in the world. So these are the highlights of this report. Thank you so much, guys. Here the video ends. I hope that you have liked this video, and if you have understood the content and liked the content, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. And a very important information for you is that you can download the PDF of this PPT from the Telegram channel, and the link of that channel is in description below. Thank you.